Hello friends, this video Trigonometry Part 8 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Before watching this video, please make sure that you have watched Trigonometry Part 1 to Part 7. Try to find other trigonometric functions. So here it says cos of x is minus 3 by 5 and x lies in third quadrant. We have to find the value of other five functions. You see all sine, tan, cos. Correct? And this is the quadrant we are talking about because this is the third quadrant and here we see cos is negative. So we have to find other values of function. So what we'll do? We'll use our mantra Pandit, Badri Pashad, Hari Hari. Bol. This is sine, this is cos, this is tan, and 1 by sine is cosec, this is sec, and 1 by tan is cot. So we have to write this and this. Before solving any questions, we have to write these thing and this thing. So if you write these two, you can solve the question. So what we see, cos is b by h, cos theta is equal to b by h. So now we'll take the values, we'll not take the signs. So it's equal to 3 by 5. So we'll assume this is x by x. That is b is equal to 3x and h is equal to 5x. Because b by h is equal to 3 by 5. So we'll assume that b is equal to 3h and h is equal to 5x. So we know that p square is equal to h square minus b square, or we can say is equal to h square is equal to 5 square, that is 25x square, minus b square is equal to 3x square, 9 square is equal to 16x square. P is equal to 4x. So we have p is equal to 4x. So now we have p, b and h, and then we can find anything. So we see sine theta is equal to p by h, and that becomes p by h is equal to 4x by 5x, and this becomes 4 by 5. Similarly, cos theta is equal to b by h is equal to b by h is nothing but 3x, b is 3x by 5x is equal to 3 by 5. Please note, I have not considered the signs now, I will consider it later. Tan theta is equal to p by b. P by b is nothing but p by b is 4x by 3x by 3x is equal to 4 by. Now let me put the sign first. Here only tan is positive, cos and sine is negative. So sine is negative, cos is negative, and tan is positive. This is the value of sine, cos and tan. Similarly, now we have to find the values of cosec, sec and cot. So cosec theta is 1 by sine theta. Similarly, cosec theta is equal to 1 by sine theta. And this becomes minus 5 by. And sec theta is equal to 1 by cos theta, this becomes minus 5 by 3, because this is a minus 3 by 5, this becomes minus 5 by 3. And cot theta is equal to 1 by tan theta, so this becomes 3 by 4. So we have all the values now. What we have done, we have used this formula Pandit Badri Prashad Hari Hari Bol, and we wrote sine cos tan, and we now know that sine is equal to p by h, cos equal to b by h, tan is equal to p by b. So we were given cos is equal to minus 3 by 5. We know from this cos is equal to b by h. So we have found p. P is equal to 4x, b is equal to 3x, h is equal to 5x. So if we have all these values, now we can find any value. And we have also used this or add sugar to coffee, all sine tan cos. So with that, we got that only tan is positive, others are negative. So we have seen only tan and cot is positive, other values are negative. Now find the value of sine and cos. Here we have to find the value of sine 31 pi pi 3. And we know that sine repeats after 2 pi, we know this. So 31 pi by 3, we can also write 10 pi plus pi by 3, correct? Because 31 by 3 by 31, this becomes 10, 1. So 10 pi by 3, 10 pi plus pi by 3. So 10 pi is nothing but 2 into 5 pi plus pi by. So if you want to write sine of 31 pi by 3, this becomes sine of 5 into 2 pi plus pi by. So we know that sine repeats by 2 pi, so we can say sine, this is equal to sine of pi by 3, because we know that sine of k pi plus x, this is nothing but sine of x, because sine repeats after every k 2 pi, sorry, sine repeats after every 2 pi, so k into 2 pi plus x is equal to sine of x. So this is sine pi by 3. Sine pi by 3 is sine of 60 degree. So how to find 60 degree? Again we can write 0, 1 by 2, 1 by root 2, 3 by 2, 1. 0 degree, 30 degree, this is 45 degree, this is 60 degree. 60 degree sine 60 degree is equal to root 3 by. We can get the values from table also, or since we have learned this 0, 1 by 2, 1 by root 2, 3 by 2 in 1. So we have used this and we have got sine 60 is equal to root 3 by. Similarly, we have to find the value of cos of minus 1, 7, 1, 0. We know that cos also repeats by 2 pi. So we can say cos of minus 1, 7, 1, 0 is equal to cos of minus 1, 7, 1, 0 plus n into 2 pi. N can be any value. Now if we divide 1, 7, 1, 0 by 2 pi is 360. Cut this. Sorry. So if you divide this by this, what we get is 72, 4, 6, 4, 24, 2, 51. So we get 7, we get 4 point something. So we'll say n is equal to 5 because we want to make this whole positive. So we'll say this is equal to cos of 1, 7, 1, 0 plus 5 into 2 to pi is 2 pi, 2 pi is, pi is 180. So this becomes cos of minus 1, 7, 1, 0 plus 1, 8, 0, 0. And this becomes cos of 90. Cos of 90, if you see, cos of 90 is, if you take cos, you have to go other way around. This is 0, 30, 45, 60, 90. This is 0. Cos of 90 is 0. So thus we have found this. We know that sine of k into 2 pi plus x is equal to sine of x. Similarly, cos in also k into 2 pi plus x is equal to sine of x. For tan, we have tan of n pi plus x is equal to tan of x. Thank you. Visit examfear.com to watch free educational videos, try free online tests, get the best quality study materials, study from the best tutors and mentors, and much more. Thanks once again.